So hey guys, welcome to the channel Learn Competitive Programming with Code Chef. So if you want to learn competitive programming and if you want to explore some good content on data structures and algorithm, so this is the prime location for you. Every week there are several videos on certain topics of DSA as well as Code Chef contest video tutorials. So if you're new to the channel, then do subscribe the channel. Myself Chirayu Jain, I'm a Code Chef educator, and in this video we're going to discuss on binary search tree on the playlist trees. Okay guys, so now let us understand what is a binary search tree, right? So we have seen what is a binary tree, what are different types of binary tree, and there are more binary trees which we can cover, like AVL trees, 2-3 trees, red black trees, right? So these are certain binary trees as well, but today we are going to discuss about the binary search tree and BST. It is one of the most prominent and one of the most frequently asked binary tree, and in most of the problems you'll find this. So let's have the discussion on that. So basically, we'll go with the definition first. So what is a binary search tree? A binary search tree is a tree where the values of the node, right? It is important to note this point, where the values of the node in the left subtree should be less than the current node, and the values of the node in the right subtree should be greater than the value of current node, right? So what it exactly means is, let us consider this example. This is an example of binary search tree. So if we see this particular node, the root node, right? This is the root node. So if we see the root node, it has two subtrees, that is a left subtree, this portion, and a right subtree, this portion, right? So it has two subtrees. You'll find that all the values in the left subtree is less than the root node, right? So you can see 1, 2, 3 are all less than 4, right? And all the values in the right subtree are greater than the root node, right? That is 5, 6, and 7, all greater than 4, right? So this is the important condition of binary search tree, right? All the values in the left subtree are less than current node, and all the values in the right subtree are greater than the current node. It is true for each and every node, not just the root node. We are checking only for the root node. It is not valid only for the root node. It is valid for each and every node. So if we see this portion as well, let's consider this as a node, right? So you will find the left subtree is this one, and the right subtree is this one, right? So one is smaller than 2 and 3 is greater than 2. Similarly, if you check this one also, right, 6, so left subtree is 5 containing only one node, and the right subtree is 7. So 5 is less than 6 and 7 is greater than 6, right? So this holds true for each and every node. So this is a typical example of binary search tree, right? So it is very important to note here, most of the students and most of the computer science geeks got confused that the difference between the binary tree and binary search tree. They often take both the trees as one, but yeah, it is a different thing. Binary search tree is different from binary tree, right? Every binary tree is not a binary search tree. There are different type of binary trees, but every binary tree is not a binary search tree. Only when in a binary tree this condition holds true, then a binary tree can be considered as a binary search tree. And whereas every BST is a binary tree, right? Because at max they can have two children, right? So every binary search tree is a binary tree, but not every binary tree is a binary search tree, right? So this is important, very important to note. So this is some of the basic introduction regarding the binary search tree. As usual, what we will do, we'll go through the implementations of this binary search tree, how we just form the logic of this, how we can code that out. So let's proceed with that how we can implement binary search tree. Okay guys, so now let us discuss how we can implement a binary search tree. So as usual, right, implementation of a binary search tree involves three basic things. That is insertion, first inserting a node. The second one is searching for a node, and the third one is deletion for a node. So in this video, we'll be considering these two operations, that is insertion and searching, which are most prominently used, right? Deletion, as there are various things involved in deletion, so we'll make a separate video of that, and we'll consider this deletion as well, right? So in this video, we'll be working for insertion and searching of a node in a binary search tree. Okay, so now let's start with some of the things in the insertion. So we know the property of binary search tree, right? So with that property, how we can insert a node, right? So let us say that we want to insert 3, and we have this binary search tree, right? So how we can do this, right? So first of all, we'll go to the root node, right, and see that what is the value of that. So the value of the root node is 4, right? We know the property of binary search tree, right? All the values which are lesser than this particular current node will be in the left subtree of this node, and all the values which are greater than this current value will be on the right subtree, right? So in this case 3 is less than 4, so we'll go to that particular left subtree and see. Okay, now we are into this, right? Now let us see which node we encountered, that is 2, right? Since now 2 is now the current node, so we'll compare 2 with 3, right? So 3 is greater than 2, that means it will be at the right position of this particular node. So that means it should be something here, right? But there are no more nodes as of now. This is the leaf node, right? There is no more node. So what we'll do, we'll make one node here and insert this 3 over here. Insert this 3 over here. That is how we'll do this insertion. Similarly, let us take one more example of 5, right? So 5 is greater than this particular root node. We'll always start from the root node, right? So 5 is greater than this particular root node. So we'll go to the right subtree. In this right subtree, we have 6, right? So since 6 is greater than 5, right? So what we'll do, we'll insert it at the left of this particular node. Why? Because, you know, all the this condition holds true for all the nodes, right? So this 5 will be at the left of this particular node. This is how we'll do insertion. Similarly, you can do insertion for various nodes. And if we want to do the searching of any particular node, that also follows the same principle, right? How we can search it. We'll compare, let's say if we want to search a value that is, let us say 5 only, we want to search, right? So first we'll start from the root node and we'll see, okay, this particular 5 will be on the right subtree, right? So we will move to the right subtree, right? And then we encountered 6. So, okay, 6 is greater than 5. That means that 5 will be lying on the left subtree of this particular node. So we'll move here and we'll encounter, okay, here we got 5. Right, so the same principle will be applicable on the searching as well. So these two operations are now clear. Now let us quickly implement binary search tree in C++. Okay guys, so now let us start with the implementation of binary search tree, the insertion and the search functionality in C++, right? Okay, so now let us see this, right? So first of all, I made one class that is node, and you know, general tree structure have three basic things, that is value, pointer to the left node, and pointer to the right node, right? So I have mentioned here that one is the integer value. I mentioned here that it is right subtree, pointing towards right subtree and pointing towards left subtree here. And now I have made two constructors, right? So one is when we make a node and which is does not contains any value, right? Generally, for, you know, if we want to make a node which is empty and want to initialize it with zero, that means that we can make a constructor which does not consumes anything, and we'll initialize this right subtree, left subtree with null and the value with zero. And one thing, when we have certain values to insert at that particular node, then what we can do, we can make a constructor with which consumes that a particular value. While we are making the object of this node, we need to give this value, and then this constructor will be invoked. And then inside this constructor, we are making the right subtree as null, left subtree as null, and marking this value with the value which we get in the input, right? So this is the two constructors that we have made for this particular class of node. Now let's see. So let's move on to the main functionality. So this is the code which helps us to get this input and the output in a particular format. So we are giving some input here, we are getting some output here. So this particular code has that particular logic. So if we want to write inside a file, then we have to give the name of the file in the read mode and the std input. And if we want to have the output in certain files, we'll give out1.txt, which I mentioned here, that file name, and then we can write it onto that. So this is particularly related to that. And if you are like just writing down the code, this won't be effective, right? For you. Okay. So now let's start with the code logic. So first of all, we are entering t. That is number of nodes that we want to enter inside the binary search tree. And then we make a tree and initialize that tree with the null, right? We made a tree and initialized that tree with null, right? So that means there is no node at present, there is only null for that tree, right? Now I want to enter certain values. So for I equals to 0, I less than t, I have entered the node values, what value should be inside the node. And then I'm calling this insert in BST. This function will consume two things, right? One is the value that we need to insert in the BST, and the second one is the reference to that particular tree. So why we are taking this as a reference here? Because we want to update in the same tree. It's not that okay, for one value I am inserting this tree, again I am giving the same tree which is null and then inserting the second value. For the same tree I want the values to be inserted. So there are two options: either we can make this tree as global, right, we can define it outside the main functionality and make it a global throughout the function, and the second thing is we can pass the reference of this, right, we can pass the reference of this tree so that all the values will be inserted at that particular location only. So this is what I'm doing here. I'm trying to pass the reference here because multiple times it will be called, right, and we need to give the tree with the updated tree, right? If some values are inserted, then we need to give the updated tree to the next call, right? So that is what I'm doing. So this is a insert in BST function. After all the values are inserted, then we'll traverse the tree, right? We'll traverse the tree. We can use any type of traversal, either in order, pre-order, post-order, right? So we can use any type of traversal here to traverse the tree. And then I am using a functionality to search certain nodes inside the tree. So search node in the binary search tree, I made a function, and then I am passing the tree here and the a value which needs to be looked on, right? So now I am passing only the tree, I am not passing the reference, because only a single time I am calling that. I am not updating anything or then I need to call it again. Here I am updating the tree and then I need to call give the updated tree here, right? Because once the value is inserted, I need to give that inserted value as well to the next call. Here I just need to search a certain value, so I am not giving that reference right here. So that's all from the main functionality, right? So after you are clear with this, now let's move how we can implement this. So first of all, let's discuss how we can insert a node in a binary search tree. So this functionality will look okay. So this is the insert in BST, right? It consumes a value and a tree, right? A reference to that tree, right? So I'm dereferencing it now. I got the reference, right? I'm dereferencing it. What I'm trying to do is I'll see that, okay, if this tree is null, right? Initially the tree is null, there is no root node present over that particular tree. So I've initialized the tree, I make that tree null. So if the tree is null, so what I'll do is I'll make one current node and initialize it with the value. And then I'll make this tree as this current, right? In the single step also I could do that, but you know, for the explanation I've done that. So I'll make a node current which will be equal to this new node, and we are giving the particular value in that, and then I'll make this tree as current and then simply return. This is what I'm doing initially for the initial step. Now what we can do is, if the tree is not null, that we need that means that we need to search at which position to insert the node. We have seen the explanation that how we need to search it, but now it's the time for the implementation. So what I'll do, I'll make a current node and initialize it with the tree, the root that we get basically, and then I'll make a parent also. We'll get to know why we require this parent, right? So while current node is not equal to null, why this condition is here? Because this condition tells us that, okay, if it is null, that means that we have reached a point where there is a leaf, right? There is a leaf node or something like that, right? So that means that we need to stop here and then we need to perform the insertion. That determines this condition, right? So now what we'll do, we'll initialize this parent with the current node, right? And then what we will do, if the same thing that we have just followed through the basic definition, through the understanding of how we can implement this, that if the value that we are that we want to insert is less than or equal to this current node, then insert in the left subtree, otherwise insert in the right subtree, right? That is the basic condition is that we need to implement it, right? So if the value is less than current node dot value, then we'll move towards the left subtree, then we'll we'll make current node is equal to current node left subtree, otherwise current node is equal to current node right subtree, right? This is the case. Now the thing, why we require this parent, why we have this parent? So we have this parent because we are modifying this current node, right? Current node will be pointing to null, but how we'll insert the node? We need to have that at what parent do we need to perform the insertion, right? So while traversing, we encountered, okay, this is null and we have reached the leaf node, but what is the parent of that null? On that parent we need to have the insertion, right? So that's why we are tracking this with the help of this parent node. Okay, at this parent we need to have an insertion. What we will check now, that if the value is less than parent parent value, that means the value which is the node value of the parent, If it is less than, that means we need to have the child as a left subtree part, as a left child part, right? So parent dot left subtree will be equal to this node. We'll make a new node and initialize with this value. Otherwise, parent dot right subtree will be a new node and initialize with this value. So this is how we are making a typical insertion in a binary search tree. There can be multiple things. There can be multiple binary search trees possible, right? This is one way of, you know, getting a binary search tree. There can be multiple binary search trees possible as well, right? So this is one way to think about how we can implement this binary search tree. Now the second thing is how we can search in a binary search tree, right? So this is the functionality of searching a node in a binary search tree. This consumes tree and a value. Now if tree is equal to null, return false, right? There is no node which is present in the tree. That means we cannot search anything, so we'll simply return false. Now what we will do, first of all, we'll make a current node and initialize with this tree node, that is a root node. And after that, while this current node is not equal to null, what we will do, first of all, we'll check that, okay, if this current node has the value that we are searching, right? So if it has the value, then what we will do, we'll simply return true, right? Otherwise, what we will do, we will check, okay, if this value is less than current node value, that means we need to search in the left subtree. Otherwise, we need to search in the right subtree. That is what we are typically doing here. And at last, if we are not able to find the node here while the traversal, and we have reached the end, the leaf portion, right? That means we are not able to find any node, so we'll simply return false. This is the pure logic for searching a node in the binary search tree. Traversal, as we can do any traversal here, like in order, pre-order, post-order, right? So I'm simply doing a traversal over here. So I am first searching on the left subtree, then printing the root, and then printing the right subtree. A sorted way of finding the things, right? So this is what I am doing here. So yeah, this is typically a traversal that we should do for printing a tree. So this is more or less the part of the binary search tree. So now let's try for this output only. There is already an output present over here, and it will be same, right? So we are inserting the same tree that we have seen in the example as well, and the output is like that, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So this is how we are printing a binary search tree, right? So this is how we are getting it, right? Now, like, if we want to search a node, so we have made this search node functionality, and we are passing 3 and value 4. So 4 is already present in the binary search tree, it is returning 1, and 9 is not present, so it is returning 0. Let's try for another values. Let us say it is something like 8. So if we build it, it will return 0. Let's say what we can say, 1. So till it is present, it will return 1, right? So that's pretty much it. And yeah, this is the functionality of insertion and searching in a binary search tree. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. If you want to explore more content like this, you can always subscribe to the channel so that you can be notified about the latest videos coming out of the channel. Also, you can join a Telegram group, right? So there also you will be notified about the latest videos coming out of the channel. The link of the Telegram group is in the description. If you want to have any comments, you want to ask any queries, you can always use the comment section for this particular thing. I'll see you in the next part.